Live, you could watch the sacred Good Friday service. Joining me now is Marion Fortner, interim rector. Marion, thanks so much for joining me.
You're welcome. Glad to be here.
Well, tell me about today's message on this Good Friday.
Well, the message, I believe, is that Christ is willing to enter into every human circumstance with us, all that's going on with us right now, even unto death. And that our hope as Christians lies in Christ, that he will redeem all and resurrect all. So that's our message today. And I hope that it's a comforting one to so many that are sheltering in place and living through these uncertain times.
The church is facing challenges like others with the COVID-19 pandemic. How have you all been worshiping?
Whew, it's been a challenge. We have been worshiping with live stream on Facebook, on our Facebook page at St. James, on Sunday mornings. And we have pared it down to just the essentials. In our tradition, we're sacramental. And so we have been celebrating the Eucharist, but we recognize that those who are participating with us are unable to take that at home. And so we just do the bare minimum, just enough so that people can feel the real presence of Christ where they are.
And I noticed you all were using masks and spreading out, but there were also a group of people putting up the cross. How do you ensure their safety against the virus?
Well, that decision was made to have the four people walk in with the cross, which is a tradition at St. James, wearing their masks. And so we all wore our masks unless we were speaking or singing. And you'll notice that they were only together for 30 seconds and that they dispersed after that. And while they were waiting, they were well spaced out, probably about 10 feet apart in the pews. And so that's how we work to ensure their safety.
Mm-hmm. And this just came in today. The governor is asking pastors to stay home for the next couple of weeks. With that in mind, how does Easter Sunday look for St. James?
Well, it now has the added challenge of a tornado warning or possibility of tornadoes. So we are evaluating that now. One thing that we could do tomorrow possibly is videotape it. Many of my colleagues are doing that. So we're watching the weather. We're certainly listening to the governor and trying to heed his advice. And we will certainly respect that and any advice that the medical community gives to us as well. And if we have to, we will send a message from our houses. We can certainly do that too.
Mm-hmm. All right. It's very difficult and very different for churches right now. Is there anything else you want to add, Marion?
I just want people to know that God loves them and that God can get through any wall and be with us wherever we are.
Thank you so much for talking to us. Have a good weekend and happy Good Friday.
Thank you.